I'm pleased to say I'm joined by one of the newest tour card holders on the PDC circuit, Darren Penhall. Darren, how are you doing?
Yeah, I'm good, thanks, Alex. Thank you for the invite.
No worries at all. And it's been an exciting start to 2020 for you, winning your tour card at Q School a month or so ago now. But I want to go back to the start for you in darts. When did you first develop an interest in darts and start playing?
I actually started playing when I was five. My dad worked for used to play darts for a local worker men's club. And I played with him a little bit. But it really took off when I was 16. I was into snooker, and I used to play snooker. And I was with my local worker men's club. And they were short on a Friday night of a dart player. So I just stood in for the evening. And it went from there. I ended up playing every week. And then county youth for Cornwall. Then county B team, A team. And I just played darts non-stop for about 10 years. That's how I got into it. Really until I was about 28. I played all the time. And then I just packed it all in, basically.
What was the just hearing what you said there? What was the reason behind giving up darts at that time?
I just had enough of it at the time. It was just all local darts, just playing local leagues and little competitions and stuff like that. I just had enough of it. I think played it for so long, week in week out. I played like three different leagues and like every little tournament in Cornwall that was going. And fancied a change at the time.
And it's a bit of a giveaway with your accent there for our listeners, but there's been a bit of confusion on Twitter. I don't know if you've seen it among darts fans with regards to your nationality. Dave Allen at the PDC informs me you played the DPA circuit in 2012 while you were working out in Australia, but your English, is that right?
Yes, that's right. I was born in Cornwall and I live in Cornwall. We had a bit of a chuckle, but actually, because it's on the darts database, I think, which other people got their information from. I went out to Australia to work from 2010 to 2013, and it was one of those times where, ever since I gave up darts when I was like 28, I've gone 3 years without picking up a dart, and then all of a sudden I'll play again for a year, and then I'll leave it go for 3 years, and then play again. But I went to Australia to work, basically, and I was out there, and I was keeping an eye on the Australian darts, and the DPA had an event that was coming close to me. Where out there you could just pay and enter it. So I thought, oh, that's right, I'll get a set of darts and I'll just go along just out of interest to see what's done. And I ended up getting to the last 16 and I won it's $45. And ever since then, I've been Australian, apparently.
So what was it like then playing the DPA circuit? Obviously not as an Australian, but as someone who's come over to work, what was it like playing on that circuit?
I was surprised. I went out there and the standard was very good. And the 3 years I was out there, I looked into the darts a little bit while I was there, even though I didn't play. I only played the one event. That's what I played. It was just the one event that came close to me. And I just went just to see what it was like. But they actually have dart clubs, whole clubs with just dart boards in it. So I was amazed, really, compared to here, where you normally go in a pub and you may have one or two boards. They literally had halls full of dart boards. So to actually see that, I'm not surprised that we won't see more Australians coming through because they've got quite a big setup out there.
Absolutely, and we've seen a few of them come over more and more now. But you obviously finish up in Australia, you come back to England, and you've spoken about you pick up the darts for a little while, then you stopped, and last year you went to Q School for the first time. What was behind the decision to give Q School a go, and how did you find that experience first time around?
Basically, it was I picked up a dart again for 2 years. And that was the October 2018, and there's a little story behind it, really. And the Plymouth Masters was being advertised on Facebook, and which was close to me. So I picked up my darts again in October. I went there in the December just to see how I would get on, and I got to the final. And in that final, I played Kyle Anderson. And I don't know how I done it, but I managed. Well, he beat me 6-5 in the final. And marking that game was Justin Pipe. And they both come to me after the game and said I should go to Q School, which was 2019. And I basically said to them, well, I don't play any darts. I won't be good enough for that. They basically said, well, you should go. Give it a go. So I iffed and ammed about it. And with the prize money that I won for runner-up, I entered. But I went to Q School and it was just too much. It was too much for me. Just so many good players, and you know, it was, yeah, it's just a big event that I wasn't used to playing in, really.
Getting to a final of an event like that you just mentioned, and going up against Kyle Anderson, running him close, must have given you a bit of confidence. And despite not doing as well as maybe you wanted at Q School, you played a little bit of the Challenge Tour as well last year, 2019. Aside from that, what else did you play in last year?
I just played two events on the Challenge Tour. I played the January one, which was right after Q School, and I played the one in May. And I actually hurt my shoulder in the June, so I didn't play any darts last year from June to October. And to be honest, I wasn't going Q School this year because I hadn't played no darts, because the plan was just to play darts all year and then go back to Q School. But I hurt my shoulder, so I couldn't throw a dart for 3 months. So it was October again, and I went to the Plymouth Masters again, and lost in the final again. And I wasn't going to go to the Q School, and then it was actually my wife that booked it for me for a Christmas present, because I wasn't going to go, because I hadn't played darts much throughout the year. So I thought, you know, I'm not prepared for something like that. She entered me, she said, I've entered it for you for a Christmas present. She said, I've got a good feeling about it. And we went, and yeah, somehow it's worked out.
Yeah, you've got to look back now, that's got to be one of the best Christmas presents you've ever got. What was the reaction when you found out that your wife had paid for you for Q School on Christmas Day?
Yeah, great. Yeah, so thank you very much, because I wasn't going to go because I hadn't played no darts, really. So I learned a lot from the year before, even though I didn't play well at all. I learned quite a lot from it. And the Challenge Tour, I went on that, I learned a lot from that, really, about you know, being behind in legs and just keep going and things like that. So the idea was to get prepared for this year that's just gone, but obviously the preparation didn't go right for that. So so it was great for her to do it, and and here we are. It's unreal, really. I'm living the darting dream.
Absolutely. And we've had a few of the tour card winners on in the last few weeks, the likes of Steve Brown, Aaron Beeney, players obviously coming onto the tour for the first time, like yourself with Aaron. And looking back at Q School, a last 32 on day two, then a last 16 on the final day, and you got your tour card via the second to last spot on the UK Older Merit. Can you talk us through what that final day was like? It must have been a very nervy experience that whole day.
To be honest, it wasn't, because I didn't know I had it. So it was one of those, I went there on the last day and I said to my wife, the only way I'm going to get a tour card is if I win the day. So I went there and I started winning a few games and stuff like that. So I didn't keep eye on it at all. And then I lost against Nick Kenny, I think, in the last 16. And then when I walked in, because this year it was in two different rooms. The year before it was all in one room. So I walked back into that room and my wife was there, and she said, friends of yours on Facebook said that you may get a card. I said no. I said I thought to myself, I got to get to the final to get a card, because I hadn't been enough for 3 days. And that's how I found out, really. So there was no nerves because I didn't know I had it. So it was a bit mad, but I just thought I had to win the last day. So I think if I knew that I was in the shell getting it, I would have probably blown it, to be honest. But it was good I didn't know.
Well, it's worked out very well indeed, and I want to come on to the European Tour qualifiers that we've just had in a moment, but I want to look first at the Players' Championship events. When we're talking, you've had the first four. How have you found the first two weekends playing on the Pro Tour?
It's been amazing. It's been amazing just to, you see these players on TV, then to actually go and play against them. It's just unreal, really. Yeah, from my perspective, I consider myself just a pub player at best, and to actually play against the best ones. And to be honest, I've made a pretty good start, I think, for what I play. I've given away a couple of games that I should have won. That's, I think, sheer of not playing anybody, really, just match. I'm sure of match practice. So it's been amazing. It's just I don't know what to say, really. It's unreal at the moment.
And one of the games I've got to talk about is with one of those best players in the world, Adrian Lewis, a two-time world champion. This past weekend, when we're talking 4-0 down, you bring it back to 4-4 with a 1-5-6 checkout, and then you miss the match starts in the decider. How do you reflect on a game like that? I suppose there's positives and negatives to take from it.
To be honest, I took all positives from it. I mean, it was a game I should have won. Adrian's playing brilliant. My son was keeping eye on the game, and he said, "Oh, the first forward legs, he was averaging, I think, 109 or something like that." And I wasn't throwing the best, and I thought to myself, if I could just get him some scores and keep with him, and hopefully he'll drop off a little bit, which he did. He did drop off a little bit, but I started playing well. So I come back, had him. But the last leg, I had a good start. I went away 180, but to be fair, I was shaking. The hand was shaking when I got to the doubles, and that's how I missed them, to be honest. It's I've been struggling with a little bit of nerves on the last two events, but I think it's just down to, not used to playing these sort of players.
Absolutely, and you made a brilliant start to the weekend. I want to look at those European Tour qualifiers, which kicked off the weekend on the Friday. You qualified for both of the first two events of the season on the European Tour. How pleased were you to do a clean sweep through those qualifiers? Because you look at it this year, all the players are in one qualifier now, and it looks like it's harder than it's probably ever been before.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, there's so many brilliant players in depth. I mean, and I think anybody can beat anybody there. It's that competitive. I mean, the averages, you can see that some of the records apparently that have been broken already this tour compared to the others. And yeah, it's to get through like I did, it's, like I say, it's just another amazing thing for me. So yeah, it's, I don't know what to say really, it's just been mad.
And I've got to mention that the final round of the first qualifier, 5-1 up against a former major winner in Robert Thornton. He comes back to 5-all to force that decider. What was going through your mind when he ran off those four legs to come back to 5-all?
Yeah, I mean, I was going quite well. I think it was just focus, really. I was into it, and I kind of eased off, and then Robert came back into it. He started scoring better. I missed a few doubles and things like that, and it came down the last leg, and I think I was lucky to take out an 80 checkout, I think, to win it. So it was a tight, another game that almost threw away, really. I think it's just an experience, I think.
You did get over the line. You're going to be in Hasselt when we're talking. It's you've got a couple of players championship events, and it will be the following weekend. When people are listening to this, it will be this weekend, the Belgian Darts Championship, the first European Tour event of the season. Just how much are you looking forward to getting on that European Tour stage for the first time?
Oh yeah, looking forward to it very much. I mean, it's a dream of mine. I've always said, because I always watched darts anyway, and I've always said, oh, I'd love to do a walk on. I'd love to do that, and I'm in the position to do it. It's just, like I say, I'm living a dream at the moment, from, not playing any darts really, to lucky enough to get through Q school, I think, because it's so tough. But hopefully I'll warrant being there. With the darts, I can play a lot better. I'm just not playing at the moment, because I'm, a bit of nerves and stuff like that. But yeah, I'm hoping that 6 months or so, I should play a lot better.
Definitely, and is your European Tour debut, your stage debut on the PDC. One of the most important questions, I suppose, is have you picked a walk-on song for that walk-on?
Yes, I have, actually. Yes, I have. Pink Rage of Glass is what I'd like. I don't think anybody else has got it. So my wife's picked it for me, actually. But yeah, so she's my boss at the moment, so I better do as I'm told.
Very good. And lastly, more stage darts coming for you next month. You're going to be in the UK Open. Sindelfingen is the second European Tour event. It's a busy schedule anyway, but adding those events on top of the Players' Championship events, how do you try and juggle both the darts and still working as well now that you are playing on the professional tour?
Yeah, I'm straight back to work as soon as I finish an event. At the moment, I'm only working probably 2 or 3 days of travelling, because I'm down in Cornwall, which even for Wigan it's like a 6-hour drive, same for Barnsley. So it's literally I'm literally working part time at the moment, 2 to 3 days a week. The boss has been good at the moment, so yeah, that's the only way I can juggle it at the moment.
Excellent. Well done on getting your tour card at Q School a month ago. Well done on qualifying for both the first two European Tour events, and we wish you all the best for this year and next year, at least, with your tour card, and thank you very much for the time.